Learn English several different topics. Belajar bahasa Inggris berbagai topik yang berbeda.
Hi! Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Let's learn English. Today, we are going to learn about the difference between what does he look like and what is he like. What does he look like? Artinya, menanyakan ciri-ciri seseorang. What is he like? Maksudnya, menanyakan sifat atau karakter seseorang. Ciri-ciri seseorang, misalnya, rambut hitam pendek, short black hair. Rambut pirang panjang, long blonde hair. Badan kurus, thin. Badan gemuk, fat. Wajah cantik, pretty. Wajah ganteng, handsome. Tinggi, tall. Pendek, short. Contoh menanyakan ciri-ciri seseorang. What does Charlie look like? What does Charlie look like? Seperti apa Charlie ciri-cirinya? Charlie is tall. He has short black hair. Charlie is tall. He has short black hair. Charlie tinggi. Dia berambut hitam pendek. What does Anna look like? What does Anna look like? Seperti apa Anna ciri-cirinya? Anna is thin. She's also short. Anna is thin. She's also short. Anna kurus. Dia juga pendek. What does Luna Maya look like? What does Luna Maya look like? Seperti apa ciri-ciri Luna Maya? Luna Maya is pretty. She has long straight black hair. Luna Maya is pretty. She has long straight black hair. Luna Maya cantik. Dia berambut hitam lurus panjang. Sifat-sifat seseorang. Baik, nice. Ramah, friendly. Pintar, clever. Egois, selfish. Pemalu, shy. Sombong, arrogant. Gaya bos, bossy. Contoh menanyakan sifat seseorang. What is he like? What is he like? Seperti apa sifatnya? He's a nice person. He's a nice person. Dia orang yang baik. What is she like? What is she like? Seperti apa sifat dia? She's a friendly person. She's a friendly person. Dia orangnya ramah. What is your friend like? What is your friend like? Seperti apa sifat temanmu? She's a shy person. She's a shy person. Dia pemalu. Menanyakan keadaan sesuatu tempat. What is Singapore like? What is Singapore like? Seperti apa keadaan Singapura? The weather is hot, but there is no traffic jam and clean everywhere. The weather is hot, but there is no traffic jam and clean everywhere. Cuacanya panas, tapi tidak ada kemacetan lalu lintas dan bersih di mana-mana.
Phrasal verbs, three words. Kata kerja frase dengan tiga kata. Drop in on. Berkunjung tanpa pemberitahuan terlebih dahulu.
We dropped in on my uncle.
Kami berkunjung ke rumah paman. drop out of. Berhenti sekolah. Tommy dropped out of graduate school. Tommy berhenti dari menamatkan sekolah. Fool around with. Bersenang-senang manakala menghabiskan waktu. My brother likes to fool around with his friends on the weekends. Adikku suka bersenang-senang menghabiskan waktu bersama teman-temannya di akhir pekan. Get along with. Akur, berhubungan dengan baik. I get along with my brother. Saya akur dengan saudaraku. Get back from. Pulang dari suatu perjalanan. When did you get back from Bali? Kapan kamu pulang dari Bali? Get through with. Menyelesaikan. I got through with my work before Saturday. Saya menyelesaikan pekerjaan saya sebelum hari Sabtu. Grow up in. Tumbuh dewasa. I grew up in Jogja City. Saya tumbuh dewasa di kota Jogja. Look out for. Berhati-hati. Look out for that car. Berhati-hati dengan mobil itu. Run out of. Kehabisan sesuatu. We ran out of drinking water. Kita kehabisan air minum. Sign up for. Mendaftar. Did you sign up for the school trip? Apakah kamu mendaftar untuk perjalanan sekolah? Let's continue learning about to be. Cara gampang menggunakan to be. Apa sih to be itu? To be adalah is, am, are. Ya, orang sering bilangnya dengan am, is, are. Subjek apa sih yang memakai to be? Nah, sekarang kita belajar dulu tentang subjek. Subjek itu terdiri dari he, she, it. I, they, we, you. Nah, to be, tadi udah belajar, terdiri dari is, am, are. Untuk he, she, it, menggunakan to be is. Sehingga, kalau digabungkan menjadi he is, she is, it is. Dan untuk subjek I, to be-nya adalah am. Dan kalau digabungkan menjadi I am. Untuk subjek they, we, you, menggunakan to be are. Dan ketika digabungkan menjadi they are, we are, you are. Kapan to be dipakai? To be dipakai untuk membuat kalimat yang tidak ada kata kerja. Contoh bukan kata kerja. Handsome, smart, cute. He is handsome. She is smart. It is cute. Contoh bukan kata kerja. Student, happy, friend, tall. I am a student. They are happy. We are friends. You are tall. Bagaimana mengatakan tidak atau bukan? Cukup tambahkan not setelah to be. He is not handsome. Dia tidak ganteng. She is not smart. Dia tidak cerdas. It is not cute. Ia tidak imut. Cukup tambahkan not setelah to be. I'm not a student. Saya bukan siswa. They are not happy. Mereka tidak gembira. We are not friends. Kami bukan teman. You are not tall. Kamu tidak tinggi. Bagaimana mengatakan apakah? Cukup memutar to be ke depan. Is he handsome? Apakah dia ganteng? Is she smart? Apakah dia cerdas? Is it cute? Apakah ia imut? Cukup memutar to be ke depan. Am I a student? Apakah saya siswa? Are they happy? Apakah mereka gembira? Are we friends? Apakah kami teman? Are you tall? Apakah kamu tinggi? Bagaimana jika waktunya telah lewat? Cukup merubah to be. Subjek he, she, it, I, they, we, you menggunakan to be was atau were. Was atau were digunakan dengan melihat subjeknya. He was, she was, it was, I was, they were, you were. Contoh bila waktunya sudah lewat. He was my classmate last year. Dia teman sekelasku tahun lalu. She was happy yesterday. Dia gembira kemarin. It was here last night. Ia di sini tadi malam. Contoh bila waktunya sudah lewat. I was a student 2 years ago. Saya seorang siswa 2 tahun lalu. They were in Bali last month. Mereka di Bali bulan lalu. We were hungry this morning. Kami lapar tadi pagi. You were tired yesterday. Kamu capek kemarin. Untuk mengatakan tidak atau bukan, dan untuk membuat kalimat tanya yang diawali kata apakah, caranya sama seperti contoh sebelumnya di atas. Menyatakan sedang. Present continuous. Cara menyatakan sedang, susunannya adalah subjek plus to be plus kata kerja plus ing. Subjek, masih ingat kan? Ada they, we, I, you, he, she, it. To be untuk menyatakan sedang ada 3, yaitu am, is, are. Dan kata kerjanya menggunakan bentuk ing. Misalnya, write menjadi writing, sing, singing, do, doing. Contoh dalam kalimat, he is eating a banana. She is eating a banana. It is eating a banana. Susanna is eating a banana. Tony is eating a banana. Jadi untuk subjek he, she, it, atau nama orang, gunakan is. Jangan lupa, kata kerja dalam bentuk ing. Dan ada tambahan kata benda. Untuk subjek I, selalu menggunakan am. Sehingga menjadi, I am eating a banana. Sedangkan untuk subjek they, we, you, dan 2 orang atau lebih, misalnya Sue and Tony, maka menggunakan are. Sehingga menjadi begini. They are eating bananas. We are eating bananas. You are eating bananas. Sue and Tony are eating bananas. He is reading a magazine. Dia sedang membaca majalah. She's wearing shoes. Dia sedang memakai sepatu. It is raining. Hari ini sedang hujan. Tony is playing a guitar. Tony sedang bermain gitar. Susanna is cooking in the kitchen.
Susana sedang memasak di dapur.
I'm watching TV.
Saya sedang nonton TV.
They are learning English.
Mereka sedang belajar bahasa Inggris.
We are discussing about holiday.
Kami sedang mendiskusikan tentang liburan.
You are standing on the stage.
Kamu sedang berdiri di atas panggung.
Susana and Tony are jogging.
Susana dan Tony sedang lari pagi. Bagaimana cara bertanya? Letakkan to be ke depan kalimat sehingga menjadi to be plus subjek plus kata kerja plus ing.
Is he eating a banana?
Is she eating a banana?
Is it eating a banana?
Is Susanna eating a banana?
Is Tony eating a banana?
Am I eating a banana?
Are they eating bananas?
Are we eating bananas?
Are you eating bananas?
Are Sue and Tony eating bananas?
Is he reading a magazine?
Apakah dia sedang membaca majalah?
Is Tony playing a guitar?
Apakah Tony sedang bermain gitar?
Is Susanna cooking in the kitchen?
Apakah Susanna sedang memasak di dapur?
Am I watching TV?
Apakah saya sedang nonton TV?
Are they learning English?
Apakah mereka sedang belajar bahasa Inggris?
Are we discussing about our holiday?
Apakah kami sedang mendiskusikan tentang liburan?
Are you standing on the stage?
Apakah kamu sedang berdiri di atas panggung?
Are Susanna and Tony jogging?
Apakah Susanna dan Tony sedang lari pagi?
Bagaimana menyatakan tidak sedang?
Susunannya adalah subjek, to be, not, kata kerja, ing.
He is not eating a banana.
She is not eating a banana.
It is not eating a banana.
Susanna is not eating a banana.
Tony is not eating a banana.
I am not eating a banana.
They are not eating bananas.
We are not eating bananas.
You are not eating bananas.
Sue and Tony are not eating bananas.
He is not reading a magazine.
Dia tidak sedang membaca majalah.
She's not wearing shoes.
Dia tidak sedang memakai sepatu.
It is not raining.
Hari ini tidak sedang hujan.
They are not learning English.
Mereka tidak sedang belajar bahasa Inggris.
We are not discussing about holiday.
Kami tidak sedang mendiskusikan tentang liburan.
You are not standing on the stage.
Kamu tidak sedang berdiri di atas panggung.
Susanna and Tony are not jogging.
Susanna dan Tony tidak sedang lari pagi. Ketika kita menggunakan present continuous tense, ada beberapa keterangan waktu yang bisa digunakan. Misalnya, now, sekarang.
Right now,
sekarang ini.
At the moment,
pada saat ini.
At present,
saat ini.
This time,
waktu ini. Contoh kalimat yang lain yang menggunakan keterangan waktu.
My phone is ringing now. Telepon saya sedang berdering sekarang. I'm not thinking about you right now. Saya tidak sedang mikirin kamu sekarang ini.
Are you watching my YouTube video this time?
Apakah kamu sedang nonton video YouTube saya sekarang ini?
I'm talking about my blog at the moment.
Saya sedang bicara tentang blog saya saat ini.
I'm not reading a book at the moment.
Saya tidak sedang membaca buku saat ini.
She's washing her hair right now.
Dia sedang mencuci rambutnya sekarang.
I'm not smoking now.
Saya tidak sedang merokok sekarang.
They are playing basketball right now.
Mereka sedang bermain bola basket sekarang ini.
He's writing a novel now.
Dia sedang menulis novel sekarang.
We are baking some bread right now.
Kami sedang memanggang roti sekarang ini.
She's not wearing a seat belt.
Dia tidak sedang mengenakan sabuk pengaman.
Are you eating my chocolate?
Apakah kamu sedang makan coklat saya?
Is she taking a bath now?
Apakah dia sedang mandi sekarang?
Are they watching soccer at the moment?
Apakah mereka sedang menonton pertandingan sepak bola saat ini?
Is he watering the flower?
Apakah dia sedang menyiram bunga?
Cara gampang mengerti tentang do, does, did. Pertama-tama, kita harus tahu kata kerja, atau dalam bahasa Inggrisnya disebut dengan verb. Dan kata kerja atau verb itu mempunyai tiga bentuk, yaitu verb 1, verb 2, verb 3. Contoh, go, went, gone. See, saw, seen. Eat, ate, eaten. Study, studied, studied. Walk, walk, walk.
Membuat kalimat dengan kata kerja. Susunannya adalah subjek plus kata kerja bentuk satu plus objek. Contoh,
I go to Bali every year.
They go to Bali every year.
We go to Bali every year. You go to Bali every year.
Tono and Susan go to Bali every year. Bila subjeknya he, she, it, maka verbnya ada penambahan es atau s. Contoh,
he goes to Bali every year. She goes to Bali every year. It eats vegetables.
Linda walks every Sunday morning. Bagaimana membuat kalimat tanya apakah, gunakan do sebelum subjek. Contoh,
do I go to Bali every year? Do they go to Bali every year? Do we go to Bali every year? Do you go to Bali every year? Do Tono and Susan go to Bali every year?
Dalam kalimat tanya, bila subjeknya he, she, atau it, maka verbnya kembali ke bentuk asli, tanpa s. Gunakan kata does di awal kalimat.
Does he go to Bali every year?
Does she go to Bali every year?
Does it eat vegetables?
Does Linda walk every Sunday morning? Cara membuat kalimat yang menyatakan tidak. Gunakan don setelah subjek. I don't go to Bali every year. They don't go to Bali every year. We don't go to Bali every year. You don't go to Bali every year. Tono and Susan don't go to Bali every year. Bila subjeknya he, she, it, maka verbnya kembali ke bentuk asli atau bentuk asal tanpa penambahan s. Gunakan doesn't setelah subjek. He doesn't go to Bali every year. She doesn't go to Bali every year. It doesn't eat vegetables. Linda doesn't walk every Sunday morning. Bagaimana jika waktunya telah lewat? Gunakan verb to. I went to Bali last year. They went to Bali last year. We went to Bali last year. You went to Bali last year. Tono and Susan went to Bali last year. He went to Bali last year. She went to Bali last year. It ate vegetables yesterday. Linda walked last Sunday morning. Bagaimana bertanya apakah bila waktunya telah lewat? Gunakan did di awal kalimat dan verbnya berubah ke verb one. Did I go to Bali last year? Did they go to Bali last year? Did we go to Bali last year? Did you go to Bali last year? Did Tono and Susan go to Bali last year? Did he go to Bali last year? Did she go to Bali last year? Did it eat vegetables yesterday? Did Linda walk last Sunday morning? Bagaimana mengatakan tidak bila waktunya telah lewat? Gunakan didn't setelah subjek dan verbnya berubah ke verb one. I didn't go to Bali last year. They didn't go to Bali last year. We didn't go to Bali last year. You didn't go to Bali last year. Tono and Susan didn't go to Bali last year. He didn't go to Bali last year. She didn't go to Bali last year. It didn't eat vegetables yesterday. Linda didn't walk last Sunday morning. May, might, maybe. We use may or might for something which is possible. We don't really know if it will happen. Kita menggunakan may atau might untuk sesuatu yang memungkinkan. Kita tidak mengetahui secara pasti jika hal itu akan terjadi. May or might plus infinitive verb. May, might, plus kata kerja tanpa to. Examples: some famous people might be there. Some famous people may be there. Beberapa orang terkenal kemungkinan ada di sana. Beberapa orang terkenal mungkin ada di sana. I may go to Bali next week. Saya kemungkinan pergi ke Bali minggu depan. Saya mungkin pergi ke Bali minggu depan. My sister might come to my house this afternoon. Adikku kemungkinan datang ke rumahku siang ini. Adikku mungkin datang ke rumahku siang ini. They might visit Singapore next month. Mereka kemungkinan mengunjungi Singapura bulan depan. Mereka mungkin mengunjungi Singapura bulan depan. What are you going to wear tonight? Apa yang akan kamu pakai nanti malam? I might wear my blue batik. Saya kemungkinan pakai batik biru. Saya mungkin pakai batik biru. How do you go there? Naik apa kamu pergi ke sana? I may go by taxi. Saya kemungkinan pergi naik taksi. Saya mungkin pergi naik taksi. Where are you going on vacation? Kemana kamu akan pergi liburan? I may go to my hometown. Kemungkinan saya pergi ke kampung halaman. Mungkin saya pergi ke kampung halaman. When we don't know the answer for sure, we can use maybe. Ketika kita tidak tahu jawaban kepastian, kita dapat menggunakan maybe. Are you going to the party tonight? Apakah kamu akan pergi ke pesta malam ini? Maybe. Mungkin. Do you want to eat out tonight? Apakah kamu ingin makan di luar nanti malam? Maybe. Mungkin. Must and have to. Must and have to mempunyai arti yang sama dalam kalimat positif. Tapi, dalam kalimat negatif, artinya jadi berbeda. Contoh dalam kalimat positif mempunyai makna yang sama. I must go now. Saya harus pergi sekarang. I have to go now. Saya harus pergi sekarang. She must come on time. Dia harus datang tepat waktu. She has to come on time. Dia harus datang tepat waktu. Contoh dalam kalimat negatif, you must not smoke at the gas station area. Kamu harus tidak merokok di area pompa bensin. Must not, di sini sifatnya peraturan keras. Jika dilanggar, Anda akan ditegur, bahkan diminta keluar dari area pompa bensin. You must not come late to the airport. Kamu harus tidak datang terlambat ke bandara. Maksudnya, kamu tidak boleh datang terlambat ke bandara. Must not, di sini bermakna peringatan sangat serius. Sebab, bila diabaikan, Anda akan ketinggalan pesawat. Berbeda dengan don't have to. You don't have to wear batik shirt. Kamu tidak harus pakai baju batik. Dalam kalimat tersebut, terdapat pilihan. Kamu tidak pakai baju batik atau kamu tetap akan memakai baju batik. She doesn't have to buy the expensive bag. Dia tidak harus membeli tas yang mahal. Dalam hal ini, dia tidak harus beli tas yang mahal. Tetapi, kalau memang ada uang lebih, boleh-boleh saja. Semakin lama, semakin bla bla bla. Semakin bla bla bla, semakin bla bla bla. Repeating a comparative. He walked faster and faster. He walked faster and faster. Dia berjalan semakin lama, semakin cepat. Your English is getting better and better. Your English is getting better and better. Bahasa Inggrismu semakin lama, semakin bagus. When you blow up a balloon, it gets bigger and bigger. When you blow up a balloon, it gets bigger and bigger. Ketika kamu meniup balon, Ia semakin lama, semakin besar. The line of people got longer and longer. The line of people got longer and longer. Antrian orang semakin lama, semakin panjang. The price is becoming more and more expensive. The price is becoming more and more expensive. Harga semakin lama menjadi semakin mahal. She's getting more and more beautiful. She's getting more and more beautiful. Dia semakin lama semakin cantik. Double comparatives. The sooner, the better. The sooner, the better. Semakin cepat, semakin bagus. The brighter the sun, the happier I feel. The brighter the sun, the happier I feel. Semakin matahari bersinar, semakin saya merasa bahagia. The bigger the party, the more food you must serve. The bigger the party, the more food you must serve. Semakin besar pesta, semakin banyak makanan yang harus kamu sajikan. The older you get, the more experienced you are. The older you get, the more experienced you are. Semakin kamu tua, semakin kamu berpengalaman. The more often they meet, the closer their relationship. The more often they meet, the closer their relationship. Semakin sering mereka bertemu, semakin dekat hubungan mereka. The less sunshine, the colder I feel. The less sunshine, the colder I feel. Semakin sedikit sinar matahari, semakin dingin saya rasakan. Learn English! Exclamations! Seruan! Exclamation is something to say when you are surprised about something. Seruan adalah sesuatu yang diucapkan ketika Anda tertegun atau terkesima. How plus adjective. What plus a plus adjective plus noun. Examples. How exciting. Betapa menarik. How cute. Betapa imut. How beautiful she is. Betapa cantiknya dia. How strong you are. Betapa kuatnya kamu. What a cute baby. Betapa imut bayinya. What an exciting movie. Betapa menarik filmnya. What cool shoes you have. Betapa bagus sepatu yang kamu punya. What a nice car it is. Betapa bagusnya mobil ini. Preposition. Beside, next to, di samping. By, near, dekat. Opposite, across from, berseberangan. Below, posisi di bawah. Under, posisi di bawah benda lain. Above, di atas, ada jarak. Over, di atas, ada kemungkinan bersentuhan. The girl is standing beside a car. The girl is standing next to a car. Wanita itu sedang berdiri di samping mobil. The girl is sitting near the car. The girl is sitting by the car. Wanita itu sedang duduk di dekat mobil. The bank is across from the hotel. The bank is opposite the hotel.
bank berseberangan dengan hotel.
There is a Japanese script below alphabet letters.
Ada huruf Jawa di bawah huruf alfabet.
The dog is under the desk.
Anjing di bawah meja.
The ceiling fan is above the bed.
Kipas angin langit-langit di atas tempat tidur.
The woman is wearing a veil over her head.
Wanita itu memakai kerudung di atas kepalanya.
Between, di antara dua orang.
Among, di antara tiga orang atau lebih.
In front of,
di depan.
Behind, di belakang.
On the left of,
on the right of.
Di sebelah kiri, di sebelah kanan.
The boy is between the girls.
Anak laki-laki itu berada di antara anak-anak perempuan.
The woman is among the children.
Wanita itu berada di antara anak-anak.
The passenger is in front of the driver.
Penumpang berada di depan pengemudi.
The passenger is behind the driver.
Penumpang berada di belakang pengemudi.
The girl is on the left of the boy.
The boy is on the right of the girl. Anak perempuan itu di sebelah kiri anak laki-laki. Anak laki-laki itu di sebelah kanan anak perempuan.
Countable nouns and uncountable nouns.
Countable nouns, things that can be counted. One book, two books. One cat, three cats. One car, three cars.
Countable nouns, for singular, we use a plus noun or an plus noun. For plural, use noun plus s. For example, an umbrella, many umbrellas. An eraser, two erasers. An egg, many eggs. A bag, four bags. A pen, three pens. A laptop, two laptops.
Uncountable nouns, things that can't be counted. Rice, a bowl of rice.
Ink, a bottle of ink.
Sugar, a spoon of sugar.
Water, a glass of water.
Look at the example. There is a sentence. We love to read novels. Can you find the nouns from this sentence?
Yes, novels.
Is it countable or uncountable? You're right, countable. Please pass the sugar.
Which word is a noun? Yes, sugar. Countable or uncountable? Yes, uncountable. Next sentence. We need some books. Books is a noun. Is this countable or uncountable? Yes, countable noun. Look at some other examples. There are two sentences by using a and an. There is a mango, I have an orange. A mango and an orange, we call it as singular countable. It's only one. There are some pens, I have some books. Some pens and some books, we call it plural countable. There is some milk. He has some ink. Without S, some milk and some ink, we call it as uncountable. Let's continue and let's practice. Choose one of the right answer by using a, an, or some. There is blank blank banana in the recipe. Can you answer the question? Yes, there is a banana in the recipe. And this is called singular countable noun. There is blank blank ice cream in the fridge. What is the answer? There is some ice cream in the fridge. Uncountable noun. I need blank blank water to wash my hands. I need some water to wash my hands. Uncountable noun. I'd like some juice. Unspecified quantity. I'd like a glass of juice. Specified quantity. Some and any. Some is used for affirmative sentences and any is used for negative and interrogative sentences. Let's practice again. I need blank blank time to study. Can you try to answer the question? Yes, I need some time to study. There is blank blank cheese. There is some cheese. There aren't blank blank horses in the field. Can you guess what is the answer? Some or any? Yes, there aren't any horses in the field. And now let's continue learning about how much or how many. How much is used for uncountable nouns and how many is used for countable nouns? How many or how much? Can you guess? How much cars are there or how many cars are there? Yes, how many cars are there? There are 6 cars. How much sugar is there? Or how many sugar is there? Yes, how much sugar is there? There are 3 spoons of sugar. How
how much pictures are there or how many pictures are there? Right? How many pictures are there? There are 6 pictures. And this is the last question. How much milk is there? Or how many milk is there? Can you guess what is the answer? Yes, how much? So how much milk is there? There are 2 boxes of milk. Thank you for watching and enjoy learning English.
Thank you.